I'm feasting on your grace. Yeah.
Oh. There are 7.6192 billion people in the world. There are 7.6192 billion people in the world. They all need Jesus. They all need Jesus. Won't you do your part? To do your part.
consecrated, Lord, to thee. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Take my moments and my days, let them flow in ceaseless praise. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
did you leave heaven's throne? Why did you humble yourself? What was the reason you came? It's all about love, love, love. It's all about love, love, love. It's all about love. This is why you came. Why did our Savior walk the road to Calvary? It was all for love. Why did he die the death intended for me? For love. This is how we live.
down at the cross where my Savior died, down with cleansing from sin I cried, and there to my heart was the blood applied, singing glory to his name, singing glory, we're singing glory, we're singing glory to his name, we're singing glory, we're singing glory, glory to his name. I've been so wondrously saved from sin, Jesus, my Savior, singing glory to his name, singing glory, singing glory, glory to his name, singing glory, singing glory, singing glory and cast your poor soul at the Savior's feet, and call out to him and be made complete, singing glory to his name, singing glory to his name, singing glory, singing glory all to his name, singing glory, singing glory, glory to his name.
Singing glory to his name. Yes, we are. Singing glory. Singing glory. Glory to his name. Glory to his name.
Welcome, everyone. Thank you guys for coming out this afternoon.
Hi, I'm Kelsey Sanchez.
And I'm Miguel Black.
And we are so excited to welcome all of you to Mississippi College and to the inauguration of our 20th president, Dr. Blake Thompson.
Kelsey and I were given the opportunity to welcome Dr. Thompson onto campus this summer. And from his first introduction, we knew he'd be a great addition to our MC family.
Even over just the past few months, Dr. Thompson has done things to make Mississippi College a greater place to live and learn, and we are so thrilled for the future.
Especially because there's barbecue involved.
So students, alumni, faculty, staff, special guests, friends, and family, thank you for joining us for this special occasion.
We ask that you will please rise and remain standing as we welcome our academic processional. It is being led by student delegates from Mississippi College's Honor Societies, and it is being followed by delegates from universities all across the country. Our future starts today. Thank you.
pray together. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. What a great day of beginning. As we look to where we've been and we celebrate the vision before us, may all that we do today bring honor and praise. We call this the invocation. Even though we do not invoke your presence is already with us. Your presence for this great institution has been for 193 years, and now we thank you for Dr. Blake Thompson. May his vision while leading Mississippi College be in concert with your will. May we never sway from being a university recognized for academic excellence and a commitment to the cause of Christ. For this is what makes MC distinctively different. May we all realize that it's not as much as this is who we are, but it's what we do through you that will last another 193 years. Father, will you help us to never forget this is kingdom work? Many lives have been and will be touched for the cause of Christ, not just here, but literally around the world. We pray for Dr. Thompson and his family, Jana, Sarah Blake, and Kate. May you protect them and guide them. May we be reminded on this inauguration day, you're able to do exceedingly abundantly beyond all we ask or think, according to the power that worketh within us. To him be glory in the church forevermore. We pray this in the powerful, precious name of Jesus our Lord. Amen. You may be seated.
Thank you, Danny Rutland, for that powerful invocation, which is a reminder to all of us that Mississippi College is an institution founded on faith. Thank you as well to the MC worship team for that great music that we enjoyed. On behalf of the Board of Trustees of Mississippi College, welcome to our beautiful campus. I don't think it ever looked better than this. This is an exciting and important day in the historic life of our institution, one that we've been looking forward to since the board selected Blake Thompson as Mississippi College's 20th president. Please join me in welcoming representatives of every branch of Mississippi College, our family who will greet the president and welcome him to the academic community. I ask that you hold your applause until they've all been introduced. Let's welcome Student Government Association President Anthony Jackson. Anthony is from Mound Bayou, Mississippi. He is a future attorney and is on track to receive his degree in political science in May. Representing the university's employees is Brittany Kinsey, president of the MC Staff Club. She's a Clinton resident and serves as assistant director of financial aid. Representing the Mississippi College faculty is biology professor Aaron Norcross of the School of Science and Mathematics. Dr. Norcross serves as president of the Faculty Council and is the university mace bearer. And representing the more than 30,000 graduates worldwide is MC Alumni Association President Scott Parrish. Scott is a 1986 MC graduate. Please join me in welcoming our campus greeters.
On May 14th, 2018, I received a phone call from my advisors, Mrs. Rebecca Benson, Jonathan Nutt, and Dr. Jonathan Ambrose, in which I was informed that Dr. Blake Thompson would like to meet with myself and my fellow student representatives the following day. My first thought and next question was, who exactly is Blake Thompson? They promptly replied that Dr. Thompson would serve as the 20th president of this prestigious university. I came down the following day to meet Dr. Thompson alongside my student representatives. And from that moment on, we knew that Dr. Thompson and his family had the capacity to truly embody what it means to be a Mississippi College Choctaw. When I first heard him give his talk about the head, the heart, and the hands, it made me reminisce of the many lessons that were passed on to me from my biggest mentors and influences in my life, namely my mother, Ms. Oneida Causley, Dr. Jonathan Ambrose, and Mr. Andy Taggart. I'm glad that I'm able to add Dr. Thompson to that list of advisors and mentors. Since I've had the pleasure of spending too much time with Dr. Thompson, I've been able to get a glimpse of the man that he truly is. He is one that loves his profession and his family. We see that being animated every day as he loves on this campus, the students that call her home, and the community that surrounds her. Dr. Thompson, in his short time here, has already left a lasting impact on this campus. He has single-handedly revitalized the atmosphere and is in the process with all of us restoring Choctaw pride. I forgot to mention how much he loves his food. Barbecue, Waffle House, ice cream. Side note, he is going on a diet after this week. On behalf of the Mississippi College student body, I humbly welcome Dr. Blake Thompson and the Thompson family to the Mississippi College family. And most importantly, I welcome them home. Thank you.
The staff of Mississippi College are honored to welcome Dr. Blake Thompson as our 20th president. From Dr. Thompson's first few days as part of the Mississippi College family, his heart and mission have been clearly visible. From becoming a secondary transportation service for students and parents in the presidential golf cart to his very presence at campus events, he has already become a significant part of our campus culture and personality. Already, his vision for the future of Mississippi College is solidifying in the hearts and minds of students, faculty, and staff. Dr. Thompson, as the staff welcomes you, we also thank you. Thank you for sharing the vision and mission of Mississippi College with us. Thank you for allowing the various parts of campus to get to know you, to welcome you, and to learn how to continue in your vision of equipping our heads, hearts, and hands. Mississippi College is known for academic excellence and a commitment to the cause of Christ in our world. As we join today, we welcome you. We pray that we all truly exemplify these characteristics as we pour into the lives of our students, their families, and our community. We eagerly look forward to being a part of your continued vision for the future of Mississippi College. May we be united together in Christ to be the hand, heart, and hands of Jesus for our campus, our city, our state, and ultimately our world.
On behalf of the faculty, it is my honor to officially welcome Dr. Blake Thompson to the Office of President at Mississippi College. As this institution's 20th president, you walk onto a beautiful campus, one that is rich in history and prides itself on providing academic excellence to our students. But most importantly, you walk onto a campus that 193 years ago built its foundation on the love of our Savior, Jesus Christ. It is this foundation that we must rely upon as we interact with each other and as we prepare our students to go out into the world so that they may excel in their chosen field as well as excel in life. Over the past 9 months, we've gotten to know you and see how you live out that mission on a daily basis. Faculty members from across campus have described you as energetic, down-to-earth, observant, engaged, outgoing and genuine, and a true barbecue enthusiast. It is these characteristics, along with your academic training and professional background, that make you uniquely equipped to lead Mississippi College into the future. As faculty, we applaud your endeavors to strengthen the head, heart, and hands of our Mississippi College community. We look forward to partnering with you and enacting your vision for many years to come. So Blake, Jana, Gray, Sarah Blake, and Kate, welcome to Mississippi College. Welcome home.
Good afternoon and welcome on behalf of the over 39,000 registered alumni of Mississippi College. I'm pleased and honored to welcome Dr. Blake Thompson as the 20th University President of our great institution. We're excited about the level of dedication to Christian higher education that I immediately noticed Dr. Thompson possesses. His commitment and enthusiasm have been welcome since the day he stepped onto our campus last year. When I began my tenure as the Alumni Association Board President just a few months prior to Dr. Thompson joining the MC family, I was excited to meet the man that God would lead to Mississippi College. As we read in Scripture in the book of Esther, I have no doubt that God chose Blake Thompson for such a time as this. At my first meeting with Dr. Thompson, it was evident that he was a student-oriented and very passionate about providing a superior education in a Christian environment. Everyone knows that college life exposes young adults to new experiences, new people, and new ideas. I have found that being a part of the alumni body at Mississippi College provides an excellent way to impact our students and the world for Christ. I found Dr. Thompson's enthusiasm to be contagious and agree with him that the alumni of our university are an integral part of the bright future of Mississippi College. Our alumni actively share their time, expertise, and resources, and we look forward to the continuation of academic excellence and the preparation of our students for the world in front of them. We anticipate continuing many great blue and gold traditions and the beginning of new chapters of success for our beloved MC. Dr. Thompson, Jana, we pray that God will guide you and bless you with wisdom as you seek after him in leading Mississippi College into the future. Thank you.
Thou and thou only, first in my heart, high King of heaven, my treasure thou art. Dr. and Mrs. Thompson have asked that we sing the beautiful hymn, Be Thou My Vision, today. I know this is a particularly meaningful hymn for Jana. You'll find the lyrics on page 25 of your program. Let's all stand out together as we sing all four stanzas of Be Thou My Vision.
Waking or sleeping, thy
Please join me now in welcoming representatives of our city, state, and nation who will greet President Thompson and welcome him home to Mississippi. I tell you, it sure does look good to look out there and see a beautiful young family like you housed in our president's home, and we are so excited about that. I ask that you hold your applause until they've all been introduced. We are always delighted to see Clinton Mayor Phil Fisher on campus. This Mississippi leader provides excellent leadership in MC's hometown. Thank you, Mayor, for being here. Other distinguished guests with the Blue and Gold family today include Dr. Jim Fertel, Executive Director of the Mississippi Baptist Convention. Mississippi College has enjoyed a fruitful relationship with the convention since 1850. Also with us is Frank Gunn, Pastor Emeritus at First Baptist Church in Biloxi. He pastored that church from 1972 until 2001. Dr. Gunn is a former board member of the New Orleans Baptist Theological Seminary and the International Mission Board, and a longtime trustee here at MC. Also, we are so thankful Mississippi Governor Phil Bryant could join us today to salute Dr. Thompson. Earning his MC master's degree in political science, the two-term Mississippi governor is truly one of us. He was an outstanding instructor on the Clinton campus when he served as lieutenant governor a few years ago. We commend the governor's leadership the past 8 years and for doing so much to promote the state's economic revival. Now, if you would, join me in welcoming our community greeters.
Good afternoon. Welcome to the city of Clinton. We're so glad you're all here. Every one of you belong here. That's our city mantra, and we're so proud that you're joining us this day for this event. The tradition of town and gown has been a long one in our city, and it's been one of great pride. As long as there's been a college, there's been a city. As long as there's been a city, there's been a college. And we've worked together for so many years together to do the right thing. I'm conducting a study right now in Clinton, and it's called Clinton Next. I want to talk to you about two points that are directly based back to our college. After talking with some 400 people in the community and asking them, what do you think makes Clinton great? Two of these things that came out was community. That was the first one. And I'll talk about that for a second. Whenever I get an email, whenever I get a letter, whenever I get a telephone call, before they start yelling at me, the first thing they tell me is, I've lived in Clinton since 1987. I graduated from MC in 1991. My grandfather moved us here in 1946. People are proud of this community, and they're proud to live here, and they're very interested in the event. So when the announcement came that there would be a new college president, everybody was interested in this announcement. The relationship is important for us to keep, and I believe that those who selected Dr. Thompson did a great job, and we're very proud to have him here, and we're very pleased that they decided to come here and join us. The second thing I want to talk to you about is education. This is one of the most educated cities in the state. As a matter of fact, in the last 5 years, not only has our high school achieved the number one rating in the state, we've had the number one football team in the state, the number one show choir in the nation, the number one band corps in the world. Mississippi College has had national championships in archery and softball, and we have the number one ranked ping pong team in the country. So there's a lot to be proud of here and a lot of variety. But the education part here, a child can go from preschool to PhD and never have to leave Clinton. That's what makes this part of a wonderful place. So to Dr. Thompson and his family, you belong here. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor, and on behalf of over 700,000 Mississippi Baptists from one end of this state to the other, I want to extend to the Thompsons a wonderful welcome to Mississippi College. If you happen to run into him and didn't know who Blake Thompson was, if you just see him out on the campus walking around, which you probably did today, you would think Mississippi College is recruiting recruiting middle school kids to come here and go to school. When I first met him, I thought, well, where's the mom and daddy? But about 2 minutes into conversation, you begin to realize the depth of not only knowledge, of life, of relationships, of the wonder of what God has done in his life. He was so young, I didn't know if he could handle this or not, but now he's so old, I know he can. And I just want to tell you what a joy it is to have him as a part of this great institution that from its very beginnings was built on a relationship with the living Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus said one time, "Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me." And learn of me. There is a wonderful thing here at Mississippi College that there's the wedding that takes place in real learning, and a kind of learning that brings spirituality and brings the kind of relationship with God himself that can take you not only through this world, but through the world to come. And so he comes with all of that kind of wonder in his life, and I'm so glad that he came here. When I first heard that he was coming, I have to tell you that he was coming from Ohio State. I just couldn't say it. And I thought, what are we going to do with a Yankee? Only to find out of the deep roots in his life and his family, in Mississippi soil, in Mississippi life, and so many wonderful things that God has done in his life. When the school began, just a little school, back in the early years of 1800s, it was called Hampstead Academy. It was the start because of folks like the mayor and folks in this area who recognized there needed to be a school of higher education in this part of the state. And so they started that little academy that would become Mississippi College. When it got its start, it was joined in partnership by the Methodists who came to try to help and encourage and to bring the same kind of spiritual dynamic that all the folks thought that it ought to have. They lasted a little while, and the Methodists couldn't continue to contribute, and so they handed it off to the Presbyterians, knowing they had a lot more money. And the Presbyterians did a great job, and they helped the school. And then in 1836, the Mississippi Baptist Convention passed a resolution saying that they were going to come alongside of this school, and Mississippi Baptists were going to embrace it and encourage their students to come here and to help this school to be all that God wants it to be. From 1836 until now, God has used that partnership and relationship and is continuing that to this very day. The Baptists believe in praying for the school, but more than that, they believe in giving to help what God is doing here. I think about Dr. Thompson, and I think about his age. He's 43 years old. Can I tell that? He's 43 years old. His wife's 20 years younger than him, but I'm trying to straighten all this out as I go, but he's 43 years old. Here's what I did in my position. I had the opportunity to go back and look at this. In the 43 years he has been on the planet, over the 43 years, Mississippi Baptists have sent to this school not only their students, not only prayers, but in the 43 years that he has lived, Mississippi Baptists have given to Mississippi College for faculty, for students, for staff, for this school to be successful. They have given over $99 million to Mississippi College. So I come to tell you, welcome. Welcome, Dr. Thompson. We are so glad that you and your family are here. And we will continue to send money and pray that God is going to bless you mightily as you lead us forth. I want to tell you, the only amen I got from the trustees was on the money part. Here's the deal. He brings vision and vitality and a voice, and God is going to use him to lead us forward. And I thank God for that. Thank you.
Well, the governor, I might as well sit down and forget about anything else. It was 1953 in the fall. I came to Mississippi College for the first time as a college freshman. That was the beginning of a love story. And over the decades, that love story has grown in my heart. But I want to tell you today, I have never been more excited than I am this day and over these months that Dr. Blake Thompson has been here. Because almost from day one, you know what he did? He embraced our vision and our mission statement. He not only embraced it, he moved it up a notch. He bumped it up because he said he wanted the entire Mississippi College family to focus on students, to see each and every student through the eyes of Christ as Christ sees them. It's a new day. Dr. Thompson has been telling us how grateful he is to be the president, to be entrusted with this responsibility. Folks, I'm here to tell you we're the ones who need to be saying to him and to his family, thank you for coming back to Mississippi to lead our great university. As I think about the future, I am to say at least some little bit of greeting from on the national and international level, and certainly Southern Baptists and others welcome the Thompson family. But more than that, I want to major on the word gratitude. Gratitude for our alumni who are all over this world serving, because that is a major focal point of our vision statement, mission statement to start with. Gratitude. Many of our graduates, alumni, occupy the most prestigious positions of leadership that you will find anywhere. Many have been so successful all around the world. Many felt a calling on this campus to take the good news, the gospel, to the ends of the earth. And they serve in remote areas even today. Oh yeah, we're grateful for our alumni. I was reading on March the 12th in the Jesus Calling book by Sarah Young, and with this I close. And Sarah Young simply said, keep your antenna up to make certain you catch a glimmer of the presence of God. When I first met Blake Thompson and I read that statement, looking back the months before when I met him, I thought, this is a great representation of this man. He keeps his spiritual antenna up so he can hear from the Father, so he can be empowered by the Father, and so he will know the leadership of the Father day by day. That's the kind of president we have. Thank you, Dr. Thompson and family, for coming back home to Mississippi.
Good evening. Greetings from the state of Mississippi. I now have 10 seconds left in this time period. I am so honored to be here as an alumni of this great university. I so enjoyed my time being a student here, even in Dr. Howard's class. I was thrilled to be able to return and teach American government, state and local government. I'm thrilled to be here with Blake Thompson, Mr. President, your family, and your supporters. Now, as I thought about how I might go about welcoming and getting us all excited about this inauguration, I've really always wanted to speak at an inauguration. Ten seconds. So, of course, we turn to the scripture. How would I look at Dr. Thompson, and what would the scripture say about him? And I thought about the prodigal son. Not all of it fits, but work with me on this one. So he left his homeland with the treasure of a great education, took a beautiful Mississippi girl with him into a foreign place called Ohio. There, only his faith in Jana kept him from riotous living. But his state and his family called back to him. We celebrated when we saw him get the finest of robes and put it on and put a gold ring upon his finger. When my son was in college, on occasion, he would come home a little late. Normally that evening or the next morning, as excited as she was, my wife, the first lady, might say, "Your son is home." Finally, my son, I thought it was ours. So as we look at our prodigal son, as we celebrate this great homecoming, I would say to you tonight, Mississippi College, your son is home. Thank you, and God bless you.
For nearly eight decades, MC students have sung the university's prayer hymn, "Savior, Like a Shepherd Lead Us," as a reminder of God's providence and care. The tradition began in the early days of World War II, as many young men from MC left to fight in Europe and the Pacific. My friend and colleague, Dr. Lewis Oswald, led us in singing this great hymn Sunday night in our community worship service. And today, as we begin a new chapter in MC's storied history, we premiere a new song based on the themes of our prayer hymn for a new generation of MC students who, like those before, must choose to answer the call to follow our shepherd wherever he may lead. You can find the lyrics to the song on page 26 in your program, and I encourage you to read along while Madeline Stanteen and MC Worship Collective debut the new song, "Savior, Like a Shepherd, Lead Me."
Give me faith, O Lord, to say, I will go. It's my happy privilege to be able to introduce our featured speakers for this afternoon, and I'll introduce all three of them together, so I would ask that you please hold your applause until I've had the opportunity to introduce all three. I do, though, want to thank and introduce Senator Roger Wicker and Mrs. Gail Long Wicker. You honor us by your presence. Thank you for being here this afternoon. I had the privilege of meeting Dr. David Williams yesterday, and I asked him, what do you call a fellow who has two doctor's degrees from the University of Cambridge? He said, David, please. I call him Dean because I so revere the role of the deanship. He did, in fact, serve as president of a college, University of Alabama, Huntsville, for 5 years. But he escaped from the presidency and has served as the dean of the School of Engineering at, yes, the Ohio State University, which is where he and our president became friends. Dr. Williams extraordinarily has authored or co-authored 13 different textbooks, spoken in 30 different countries. I'm trying to make every county, you understand. And has the remarkable distinction, among other things, of having just been named to the Royal Aeronautical Society. I would really like to be in the Royal Aeronautical Society. Dr. David Williams will be our first featured speaker. You know, the passage at the end of Luke chapter 2, where we're reminded that Jesus grew in wisdom and stature and in favor with God and man, runs the risk of us believing that we're sort of four-part beings. And Dr. Futrell, Dr. Gunn, I understand we're not. We're singular beings. But there are respects in which the Lord expects for us to mature. And Dr. Williams surely shows us maturity and professionalism and wisdom and knowledge. The Honorable Regina Schofield, who is a personal friend of the Thompsons, helps us remember what it means to be walking and growing in favor with God, because her entire career has been in service to the people around her. She currently works for the Battelle Memorial Institute. You should look it up. It's an amazing thing. It's the largest nonprofit technology and research institution in the entire world. More about that in a few moments. But prior to that, she worked for the Casey Family Foundation, helping foster children. We are rightly asked, what do we think about children after they are born, we who are so devoted to protecting children before they are born? And Regina Schofield has demonstrated with her life what she thinks of children after they are born. She has had the distinction of having been confirmed by the United States Senate as Assistant Attorney General for the Department of Justice over the Office of Justice, whose role it was to interact primarily with minority Americans and help work through the difficulties that all Americans, and in some respects disadvantaged minorities even more than other folks, have in engaging the resources of government. And then she had the privilege of serving in the Bush White House, the George W. Bush White House's intergovernmental affairs. She did work that was designed to help prisoners, Dr. Pickett, re-enter back into ordinary society after having served their debt to society, growing in favor with God. And then growing in favor with man, is there a person in our state who is more universally liked than Dr. Mark Keenum, president of Mississippi State University? Anybody in any role of significant influence and leadership over some period of time is bound to take some incoming. But if Mark Keenum ever takes incoming, it's completely off the radar screen because he's unflappable in every respect, in every opportunity that I've ever had to see him in a public setting, and genuine and warm and kind in personal settings. Some of you may know Dr. Keenum and our Dr. Thompson became acquainted and professional colleagues in the service of the United States of America in United States Senator Thad Cochran's office. He was chief of staff for Senator Cochran for an extended period of time. A number of degrees in agricultural economics. He knows what it means to seek the fruit of the work of hands, and consequently what it means to grow in favor with man. Would you help me welcome, please, Dr. David Williams as our first featured speaker.
Thank you, Andy. Whenever I get dressed up like this, my wife, Margie, raised in Australia, says she's reminded of a parakeet. And that may be the case, but this outrageous plumage actually contains the long history of relationships between the Christian Church and universities, and indeed politicians, This is termed a Tudor bonnet, reflecting the dynasty of kings that founded many colleges, including my own Christ College in Cambridge back in 1505. This hood, if I could ever get it on, would remind you of a monk's cowl, because the monasteries were the academic houses of the time, and they were burned in their hundreds by another Tudor king, Henry VIII, who disliked the views that the academics of the time had about his divorce. So when we bemoan the ongoing challenges between politicians and professors and pastors, it's been going on for 500 years, so this is nothing new. Veritas et Virtus, the motto of this college, truth and virtue. Tough to find these days, and it was tough to find 500 years ago. So, a few words for you who have to work with Blake so that we can continue to build truth and virtue at Mississippi College. In fact, for all of you who are working with Blake, I just have two words. Diet Coke. Never have a meeting with Blake unless he's had at least six Diet Cokes. You won't get anything done. And I have a word or two for Blake. His attention span is short, so how about academic excellence? Something that's talked about a lot, but is achieved rarely. However, you were very fortunate in having Blake, because he had the right upbringing such that academic excellence was inbred in him. His parents, who are here today, both teachers, ensured that Blake became the first in his family to get a doctorate, and he brings that academic excellence to everything that he does. In Northwest Columbus, that's in Ohio, Battelle Memorial Labs and the Ohio State University share a few square miles, and in those few square miles, they spend $13 billion every year on education and research. There is no greater concentration of academic excellence anywhere in the world. And only one person in the history of those institutions has been the vice president of both, that is Dr. Blake Thompson. It's been my pleasure to work with Blake for many years at Ohio State University. He's my colleague, he's my good friend, he's my co-conspirator. We've worked together in bringing great faculty to Ohio State University and in creating the Proposal Development Center at Ohio State. These projects took years. Blake understands that academic excellence requires commitment, it requires collaboration, and it requires trust. And Blake brings all of those in great depth to this institution. The head and the heart and the hands. We've heard that a lot today, and that's again what Blake brings, and with that will come academic excellence to Mississippi College. But none of that would have happened without Jana, because those of us who know this couple know that in this marriage, the trailing spouse is Blake Thompson.
I met Blake in 2001 while working at the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services under President George W. Bush. I like to say that he came to a meeting so he could check on me. He was relatively new with Senator Cochran's staff, and unbeknownst to him, I had actually been a liaison with Senator Lott's staff when I worked at the Department of Education for President George H.W. Bush. So I actually knew how to liaison with congressional staff. Working with my home delegation was not new to me, but I digress. Blake and I both have a passion for taking care of our home state. That day, I was hosting a meeting for the University of Medical Center staff and talking about ways to help them and the state in any way that I could in my role. Over the years, Blake and other members of Senator Cochran's staff brought me home to Mississippi on site visits, always looking for ways to improve services for the citizens of our state. Our business relationship had quickly morphed into a friendship. And at some point, we figured out we were neighbors. We literally lived 2.5 blocks from each other. and I met Jana. She was a pharmacist at the hospital where both of my children were born. Isn't she an amazing woman? Over the years, we swapped crock pot recipes, dishes. We took dishes to each other when our kids were born, when people were sick. All of those dishes were cooked with love. Have you ever been homesick? I moved to DC almost 30 years ago, and I used to stop by my senator's offices so I could hear Southern voices as they answered the phone. I was in a town where traffic was insane and still is, and people were not genuinely nice. By the time I met Blake and Jana, I had grounded myself fully and realized that faith, family, and friends can and will carry you through when times are rough. Once, when I was employed at the U.S. Department of Justice, I was having a hard time with the senator's office, and I decided to walk down to Jana and Blake's house so I could talk it over with them. I showed up uninvited. They had a house full of family, but they welcomed me in. I told Blake about the problem that I was having, and he said not to worry about it. I didn't fret about it anymore, and I didn't get a hard time from that senator's office ever again. Blake recruited me to my current employer. He and Jana made Columbus, Ohio a second home for me. And I have to tell you, they're not there. And sometimes when I have to go back for business trips, I'm lonely. I miss them. But let me be clear, from day one, they made it clear that they were coming home to Mississippi at a young age so they could sow good seeds, maybe grow some blueberries. Wednesday, when I called Jana to say what time I would be coming in on Thursday, she said, come on to the house, the door will be open. What I heard was, come on, Regina, the door is always open for you. With the Thompsons, I'm home. I am loved unconditionally. And I'm overjoyed that they are here at MC, my first home away from home. A place where I grew in confidence and matured knowing that my professors had my best interest at heart. A place where your children will grow and thrive, grow in confidence, and be loved unconditionally. What a blessing. For me, our students, the community, and the world. What a complete circle for me that the Thompsons are here at my alma mater. You can feel the authenticity in their love and caring. I am honored to have them in my life. Under Blake's leadership, the future is full of promise, innovation, and grounded in faith, family, and friends. I begin my close with the second great commandment. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. With the Thompsons, we see an humble, sacrificial, serving love that Jesus commanded of us in the Gospel of Matthew. I close with Romans 13:10. Love is the fulfillment of the law.
Good afternoon. What a beautiful day the Lord has made. And might I also point out that this is a beautiful Maroon Friday. I bring greetings from Mississippi State University and all of our campus to this great campus on this historic day for Mississippi College. And the fact that I'm here today on this beautiful college and not in Portland, Oregon with our women's basketball team, it proves how much I love and respect your new president. I remember when I first met Blake Thompson. He came to Washington, D.C. in 2000 to serve as a health policy fellow for the office of Senator Thad Cochran. In fact, he was the very first fellow to fill that position to what later became a hugely successful program in the senator's office. After his one-year fellowship, Blake returned to the University of Mississippi to complete his PhD in pharmaceutical sciences. But I must say, he left a terrific impression on all of us that he worked with. In fact, he did such a marvelous job during his fellowship, we invited him to come back to Senator Cochran's office and join our staff as a legislative assistant for health affairs in 2002. In 2005, he was named legislative director in Senator Cochran's office. To me, that illustrates his immense talents. He had a thorough command of very complex issues and an understanding of how they would impact our state and our nation. He also possessed remarkable communication skills and could articulate even the most complicated and arcane policy issues. He was also great with people, with colleagues, constituents, everyone he came in contact with. And I have so marveled at his career achievements, most recently at Battelle and The Ohio State University. So it's quite easy for me to see him here today as the president of this outstanding college. Not only is Blake Thompson highly intelligent, with a great sense of humor, I might add, but he's also a man of very high, in fact, the highest of integrity, truly a hard worker, and someone who has great respect for all. These are values that we hold dearly at Mississippi State University: integrity, hard work, and respect. And Blake has exemplified these qualities for all the many years that I've had the pleasure of knowing him. And like Dr. Futrell said, the only challenge that I can think of that he's going to have here leading this great college would be that if you were to see him walking across the campus in a pair of jeans and a Choctaw t-shirt, you would assume he was a freshman. Maybe a sophomore, maybe, I don't know. But in all the years that I've known Blake, I can tell you this, he has never let his youthful good looks hold him back. So my dear friend, enjoy it while it lasts. Well, in all seriousness, Blake and I have both been truly blessed to have served a great leader like Senator Thad Cochran. He taught us a lot. Senator Cochran, he did teach us how to respect people. He also taught us how to make decisions. He taught us that leaders must make decisions based on facts, never rumors or hearsay. And leaders should always know who's for it, who's against it, and why. As I said, Blake and I were blessed to work with such a great leader like Thad Cochran, and we continue to benefit from his lessons. Senator Cochran is a true statesman. He's always, all the many years that I've known him, he's been very approachable, and he's very humble. I'll never forget Senator Cochran telling me one day of a meeting he had had with a group of ladies from Northwest Mississippi. And after the meeting was over, one of the ladies went back into the office to thank him again, but she said, "Senator, I've just got to tell you, I think you are an eloquent listener." He later told me that that was probably one of the greatest compliments he ever received. I tell you this because Dr. Blake Thompson embodies all of these values: humility, integrity, hard work, respect, and he is someone who listens. He is an empathetic listener. In fact, I would say, like Senator Cochran, he is an eloquent listener. So to you, the faculty and the staff, the many wonderful alumni, and all the many friends of this great college, and all of us as Mississippians, we're all truly blessed that Blake and Jana and their wonderful family are back home in Mississippi. I know that President Thompson will lead Mississippi College to even greater heights, and help move our great state forward. Blake, to you, my dear friend, Godspeed, congratulations, and may God bless you all. Thank you.
Good afternoon to you all again. And I want to thank the previous speakers we've had thus far in the program and what an excellent job they've done in highlighting our president, Dr. Blake Thompson. Now it comes to the focal point of today's ceremony, the investiture of Dr. Blake Thompson as the 20th president of Mississippi College. Dr. Thompson, will you please join me at the podium? We, the trustees of Mississippi College, have selected you for the presidency of this venerable university. By their order, it is now my distinct honor to invest you with all the dignity, privileges, and authority of this office in the great state of Mississippi, and we pray that you will be granted wisdom, patience, courage, humor, and strength to do all the things required of you with the blessings of God on this day, March the 29th, 2019. Now, it is now my honor, Dr. Thompson, to present the formal symbol of your office. I'd ask Dr. Bo Roberts to come join me here at the podium, please. While he's coming, joining us at the podium is a distinguished Mississippi College business professor and administrator for decades, I won't say how many, Dr. Lloyd Bo Roberts. The former dean of the School of Business, Dr. Roberts served as interim president in 2001 and 2002. Now, Dr. Thompson, I am commissioned by the Mississippi College Board of Trustees to present you with the chain of office of the university president. It represents the responsibility of the institution's highest honor of leadership and reflects our historical connection to a system of higher education that is nearly two centuries old. You are called upon to wear this chain at all academic functions. Now, Dr. Roberts, if you'll chain him. Now for sure. Now, we don't have but one.
Not broken.
That's not broken.
Yes, our president broke the chain, yes. Thank you for teaching us about wisdom, Dr. Williams, about favor with God, Ms. Schofield, about favor with man, Dr. Keenum. And by the way, Dr. Keenum, in return for your graciousness in being here rather than in Portland, Oregon right now, ich bin ein Lady Berdogger. Good luck, good luck. I tried to think about ways not to simply repeat back to you all what you can find either in the program or online about Blake Thompson. By the way, if you look online, you'll be looking for a long time because a lot of good things have been written about this man. And his academic credentials are absolutely worthy of acknowledgement. They're significant. 3 degrees in a row from the University of Mississippi, finishing in the PhD. His professional credentials are worthy of mention. They are significant. Services has already been mentioned in the office of Senator Thad Cochran, then on the staff of the Senate Appropriations Committee, through which literally flows hundreds of billions of federal public dollars. Service for the Battelle Institute at Oak Ridge National Lab, you should look that up too. You'll find something about the Manhattan Project. That was, of course, way before our president was there, but it's an indication of just how important, first of all, that laboratory is in our nation's history, but secondly, what a critically important role Battelle is playing all over the world today. And then Battelle moved him to Columbus, where he actually served both institutions, both Battelle and Ohio State, for a period of time before taking the role that he served in just before joining us. But rather than trying to simply regurgitate all of that, it struck me that there might be some wisdom in trying to find a biblical parallel for leadership at this stage in this man's career and at this time in the history of this institution. And the biblical Joshua came to mind because he followed what can only be described as a wildly successful predecessor. Moses had done what no one predicting at the beginning of his life would ever have thought could have been done. Now, I'm not suggesting for a moment that Dr. Lee Royce could have raised a staff and parted the Red Sea, but I am suggesting to you that the predecessor who served before Dr. Thompson has left this institution in extraordinarily sound shape and provided extraordinary service to the Lord, to the community, and to this school. But you know, there's a passage in Exodus chapter 14 where the people are trapped between the Egyptians on the one hand, the Red Sea on the other, and God says to Moses, raise your staff and tell the people to calm down and let's see what happens overnight. And a strong east wind blew overnight, and the people, as you know, were able to go over the Red Sea on dry land. And no doubt they thought that if Joshua was to be the new leader, surely he also would help them cross on dry land whenever they faced the flood. But no, it was not to be. In fact, in Joshua chapter 3, what we find out is the river was flooded as they looked across to see the promised land. So close they could taste it, but the river was flooded. And God did not say to Joshua, go down to the riverbank and raise your staff and y'all wait overnight because I'm going to blow the river back out of the way. That is not what he said. He said, tell the priests to go jump in the river. Well, that's my paraphrase. He said, tell them to go step into the river. And so they're 200 yards away. The river's still flooded. They're 50 yards away, the river's still flooded. They're 10 feet from the river's flooded bank, and it's still flooded. And not until the priest stepped their feet into the water did the water roll back. Now, I don't know what the Lord's going to do. We'll have floods of crisis. We'll have floods of opportunity. We'll have floods of danger. We'll have floods of joy. I don't know what the Lord has in store for the time that he has Blake Thompson here with us. But I suspect that it is fair for us to predict that we will face floods of some kind. And I don't know in what way the Lord will choose to roll it back. It may well be that he doesn't. Maybe he says you have to jump in the river. But I will tell you one thing. When you look on social media and you see a squinchy-eyed guy who looks like he's about 30 years old, it's not because he's mad at anybody. It's because he's got an idea about something. And by the way, I've not left out stature. And by the way, Dr. Thompson, I don't think growing in stature means eating more barbecue. It means becoming the man the Lord created you to be. And thank the Lord that you have done that to this stage of your life. And by the way, about the only person who thought it was a good idea to do this outside this afternoon was Dr. Blake Thompson. And thank you, Lord. But whatever the Lord chooses to do about the floods that will come in the future of our institution, I'm absolutely confident that with Bunyan's cheerful and Christian, when we start to feel as though the billows are going over our head and we're not going to make it, we're going to hear Blake Thompson say, take cheer, friend. I've touched the bottom, and it is firm. Would you help me welcome and congratulate our 20th president, Dr. Blake Thompson?
Thank you, thank you, thank you. Good afternoon. Thank you, Andy. Sometimes I think the only thing tougher than following Baptist preachers is following Andy Taggart. I am indeed honored by the kind words of our speakers today. And students, most of you are kind of sitting around the back, standing in the back. Some of you came from class and practice, and I'm honored that you're here. You're why I'm here, and I'm thankful, and I start all of my thinking with you. And I also want to thank all of you for coming out on this incredible spring day. The season of spring has come to Mississippi College, to Mississippi almost 200 times. Since Mississippi College was first chartered in 1820. 26. We are approaching a 200th birthday, and I have the awesome responsibility, as only the 20th president, to plan for and usher in that bicentennial celebration, which we're already planning to be right here on this quad. And let me stop and say a special thank you to all of those who labored over the last weeks and months to prepare this beautiful place. You've honored God with your work, and God has then looked favorably upon Mississippi College for almost two centuries. And today, I get to help us look forward to an incredibly bright future. Thank you for celebrating that future with us. Many of you also know that the Thompson family is also celebrating coming home. We came back to Mississippi to be here on this spring day after living in Ohio for 9 years. And we loved our time in Ohio, except for perhaps the polar vortex and the cyclone bomb, which would descend on Ohio in the winter. I absolutely hate being cold. So much so that just last month, we were anticipating a rare Mississippi snowfall. And having lived up in the frozen north, I made the decision to cancel classes. We ended up with that dusting of snow, and I didn't even have to wear a jacket that day, while Columbus, Ohio was a negative 30 wind chill. And yes, I've gotten a lot of grief from my Ohio State friends, several of whom are here today. Ohio State friends, I don't regret it one single bit. And I don't miss the cold at all either. But my family and I did miss something even more important. We missed home. And coming to MC meant we were coming home. And home is where you two or more people are always called y'all. Home's where you can always find real Southern barbecue, many times at a gas station. Home is where so many people share the same values that mean so much to Jana and me. And no matter where our families lived, Jan and I have always made it clear that we were Mississippians first. And we always seem to find reminders of home as well. For example, one day at Ohio State, I had the chance to tour the offices of J.P. Morgan Chase. Some 10,000 employees in what seemed like 10,000 cubicles. And something caught my eye on that tour. So I left the tour group to go investigate, and I found a coffee mug emblazoned with the word Mississippi. Mark Keenum, it was actually a Mississippi State coffee mug. And that maroon never looked so good. We're all cheering for the Bulldogs today. Friends, I tell you that story so you'll know that even though we've spent many years away, my heart's always been here. And now I'm excited to be able to put my heart and my head and my hands to work in my home state of Mississippi at an institution that bears its name. Mississippi College is a university recognized for academic excellence and a commitment to the cause of Christ. It's the core of who we are, it's the core of who our faculty and staff are, and it's who our students are becoming. Now, my Ryanzi, Mississippi way of describing that is to use the phrase head, heart, and hands. So you see, we believe that when our faith, our heart, animates our academic and our professional pursuits, our head, that's when we find our calling. And here at MC, our calling animates the way we serve others. It animates us in a way that means we truly love and serve our neighbors. When I talk about this service, I'm using the word hands. I love that phrase that we're the hands and feet of Jesus. But first, I want to look at what we're doing with our heads. MC's academic programs are simply outstanding. and South Hall, just behind us. I've seen the future of a business world, not based on the bottom line, but on an ethic of honesty and integrity. I spent a lot of time in Jennings Hall on this side of campus, which is one of my favorites, in part because of its brilliant architecture, but more importantly, because of the brilliant professors inside, and in part because they made a banner of the first time I said that. Thank you, Tracy Harrison, for that banner, but also to Sheila and Laura Ann and all of you who've joined Tracy in this effort to put today together. Yes. Now, I've also visited Avon Hall, where I've heard our faith expressed through ancient hymns and through new original music that we're sharing with people in countries around the world. You've experienced a lot of that music today, and we've experienced on this campus this week. Well, Bishop, thank you, and thank Worship Collective and the MC Singers for all the work you've done this week. MC is also home to a renowned medical sciences program that will produce the next generation of healers and medical researchers. I'm thankful to one of its alums, Dr. Dan Jones, for leading our academic symposium yesterday and sharing how intellectual pursuits and our service to others take us sometimes to the other side of the world. In his case, to North Korea. Yes, that North Korea. MC leaders do amazing things in amazing places. Now, I need to pause and say that while I've been to the other side of the world as well, I confess that I have not visited the medical science program's cadaver laboratory on the other side of the quad. They keep inviting me, and I keep saying no. They keep telling me there are plenty of heads and hearts and hands in that laboratory, and I keep saying no. And to that faculty member who keeps sending me a Google schedule invitation, I know that room 203 in medical sciences is not your office. Nice try, but my head is smarter than that. What I love about all these programs, though, is that they're developing and challenging a future's worth of leaders. They're training future healers and future teachers, future musicians and entrepreneurs, writers, social workers, and sundry others who will go to work in fields not even imagined. They're the next generation of faithful MC leaders. I've seen what they can achieve when their faith animates their academic and professional pursuits. And I'm excited to announce to you today, in the coming fall semester, we'll be adding two new academic programs here at Mississippi College, both aimed at continuing our work of shaping the heads and hearts of future leaders. First, I'm pleased to announce today the creation of the Honors College at MC. It's made possible by a very generous gift from our friend J.L. Holloway. The Honors College will strengthen incredible students whose academic pursuits are animated by their faith. And just as our sister Honors Colleges across this state do, we will seek to attract new students to Mississippi and to keep Mississippi students right here at home. And today I'm overjoyed to actually introduce to you the 14 members of that inaugural class of the Honors College at MC. They are here today as my special guest. Allie and Kaylee, Ridge and Austin, Avery and Aaron, Tori and Todd, Brennan and Gracie, Marion and Luke, Elizabeth and Tyler, please stand so that we can recognize you. Please be seated. I look forward to your recognition as outstanding students and leaders on our campus. I fully expect one of you to be our first MC Rhodes Scholar. And I fully expect several of you to win national championships. You already know who you are. And I fully expect all of you to go and serve in places like North Korea in Northeast Mississippi. And I can't wait to see how you're going to change the world. The Honors College is not the only new program we're announcing today. As part of our Baptist heritage, MC takes seriously the Great Commission. In fact, our gates in front of Provine Chapel tell us to depart to share our culture with all mankind. In order to do that, we're creating the McMillan Center for Education Abroad, led by Dr. Beth Stapleton and named in honor of the late and beloved MC Professor Edward McMillan. Yes. We're standing on his shoulders. The Mac Center will develop even more opportunities worldwide for our students and faculty. As Dr. Stapleton has so often reminded me, when we share our culture, we also grow in our understanding of others. We see life's struggles and triumphs are not all limited to Clinton or Mississippi or even the United States. And we also realize life is more precious and more real than you'd see on Facebook or Instagram or Twitter. I'd be remiss if I didn't ask you to follow me on Facebook and Instagram, Twitter. Our Mac Center is going to share the MC story in a very real way, and it will expand our capacity to love others who are different than we are. Said differently, our heads will be challenged to share our culture, and we trust our hearts will be softened as we interact with others across the globe. Now here at MC, our faith animating our action around the world does not come without risk. When I arrived at MC, one of the first three students I met was Emily Hankins. All three of those first students are seated together today in the front row. Emily, Bell, and Kyle, thank you for being a part of this today. It was very soon thereafter that Emily was the first to volunteer to sing at my inauguration. And I'm thankful she did that so beautifully this week in Provine Chapel. Now, what you don't know is that Emily almost wasn't here to sing this week. Emily just returned from Cambodia during the Christmas break, where she was serving with Hard Places Community, a mission organization dedicated to children and survivors of human trafficking. Emily had already been there once, and she went back, but this time she contracted dengue fever. Dengue is a debilitating mosquito-borne disease that can be fatal. When Emily decided to return home to be treated, the doctor in Cambodia told her, "I don't think you're going to make it home." Well, by God's grace and Emily's determined spirit, she did get home, where she spent a week in critical care in the hospital. During part of that time, she was actually completely packed in ice to reduce her fever. She's only just now beginning to feel like herself. But illness, the threat of death by dengue, and all that ice didn't change Emily's heart. In fact, her heart burns brighter than it ever has before. This summer, Emily's going to go to Portland, Oregon with GenSyn, an arm of the North American Mission Board, where she'll learn about church planting and serving those who need it. Emily said just this week, "My heart's in the hard places. I'm ready for another challenge, and I want to take my faith to another place that's hard." And then she continued, "But maybe this time I'll find one with fewer mosquitoes." Emily, we love you, and we're thankful for you. Anthony Jackson is another MC student whose heart has been changed. He's on the stage with me. You heard from him a moment ago. Anthony had his heart set on a Division I college football career. And just maybe he would have played in the NFL. Until a series of devastating injuries ended that dream. Anthony, though, because of those injuries, was elected MC's first African-American student body president. I'm thankful. I'm thankful every day that I've been able to serve side by side with him. And now we look forward to even greater things. Now that Anthony, with the encouragement of our trustee and my introducer, Andy Taggart, Anthony has recently announced that after graduation in a few weeks, he's returning home to Mound Bayou and running for the Mississippi House of Representatives. Folks, Folks, Anthony Jackson suffered two broken legs during his football career, but he's running better and he's running stronger than ever before because of a heart that's been changed at MC. These students and 5,000 others like them are following their hearts down a path God has put on them. MC's part of that path, and I need to acknowledge the faculty members along that path who love them. These professors are pouring their hearts into our students, and I'm honored to serve alongside them. I'll give you the short version of a story I've been telling about one of those professors. This fall, another one of our students ended up in intensive care, this time at the medical center in Jackson. I went down to see her after she got out of the ICU. She proceeded to tell me a story in vivid detail. She was a pre-med major. Of waking up that night, becoming terrified and panicked. In the ICU, she had a tube down her throat. And then she looked over to see one of her MC professors holding her hand. And she told me, she said, I knew everything was going to be okay. You'll have to come back to hear the rest of this story. But this is the work of an MC faculty member. And when you come back, I'll show you the work of another distinguished faculty member, Dr. Sam Gore. This morning, we dedicated an amazing sculpture just past Provine Chapel by Dr. Gore. See, Dr. Gore uses what's in his head and in his heart, and he pours it into clay, and he literally uses his hands to shape the clay. There's even a book about Dr. Gore's amazing career called Blessed with Tired Hands. Those are his hands. Earlier today, I was able to present my wife, Jana, a set of hands made of clay, molded in real time during our luncheon by one of Dr. Gore's students, Carrie Reeves. These hands signify the service that Jana and I hope to provide during our time here at MC. As I begin to close, I want to thank those of you who have already served this week. Jen and I chose three areas of service to highlight this inauguration. We first chose those who are planting churches, both locally and across the globe. We're thankful that our dear friend and church planner, Josh Manley, was here earlier this week to preach at our community worship service. Josh is back today. What you should know is that he came all the way from the United Arab Emirates, just across the Persian Gulf from Iran, where he serves with his wife, Jenny, and their five children. Josh, thank you for going where you've been called. The second area we chose was food insecurity. There are still hungry people in our community and in our state. Tuesday, I spoke at chapel. Of course, my topic was food and barbecue. Following chapel and the lunch that followed, many of you joined us to literally use your hands to prepare food for those in need. I thank Extra Table and the Four C's for partnering with us. And I thank an incredible staff from across this campus who served all day on Tuesday. You are the backbone of this institution. And finally, we chose to highlight foster care and adoption this week. We believe there's no greater example of loving others with all your head and your heart and your hands than to foster and adopt children. I wish I could thank all of those who served with us this week at places like the Baptist Children's Village and Canopy Children's Solutions. I wish I could name all of those foster and adoptive parents that we admire so much, like the Ambrose family, the Followell family, the Wallace family, and the Mansell family. And those are just the ones within walking distance of my office in Nelson Hall. Yeah. And finally, I wish I could thank every single Mississippi College law student who has worked with the Mississippi College Legal Adoption Clinic. Crystal Welch leads this group. I met her on my very first visit to MC Law. Her students put their legal knowledge to use in a hands-on way, finalizing adoptions for kids in foster care and the people, the families who are desperate to become their moms and dads. And our students do this work at no cost to the families. The Adoption Legal Clinic has helped over 200 children join permanent families in just the past 2 years. I was able to join Crystal over the Christmas break at an adoption ceremony, and then again Tuesday, during our day of service, in a packed Hinds County Chancery Court, where MC's most recent team united 17 children with new families. Here's a picture of one of them. He held my hand, and he captured my heart. Now, I want to leave you today with some words from one of my absolute favorite Mississippians, Elvis Presley. Those of you who know me should have expected that something like this was coming. That's Elvis. That's my mom, who's officially very worried right now. And that's my dad, who's enjoying it. I have a lot of favorite Elvis songs, but the one in particular that seemed perfect for my talk today, especially as I talk about using our hands to serve children, the least of these, as Jesus called them. Elvis didn't actually write this song that I'm talking about, but he made it famous when he sang about a hungry little boy with a runny nose who plays in the street as the cold wind blows in the ghetto. He goes on to tell the tragic ending of that young man's life. And in this song, which is just as relevant today as it was when it was released exactly 50 years ago this week, Elvis went on to sing, "People, don't you understand? Child needs a helping hand, or he'll grow to be an angry young man someday. Take a look at you and me. Are we too blind to see? Or do we simply turn our heads and look the other way?" My prayer for Mississippi College is that our hearts, and for many of us, our faith, will never ever allow us to turn our heads and look the other way. But instead, that our hearts, our faith, will animate the thoughts in our head, and that our faith will animate the actions of our hands to serve those who need it most. May God bless this noble mission of Mississippi College. Thank you.
Now, speaking of Elvis, you were born and raised about 40 miles from where he was born in Tupelo, and I was born and raised in Memphis, down the road from Graceland. So I thought it'd be a good idea today that we include a little Elvis music in today's ceremony. Now, you referenced a song in the ghetto that explains the idea of head, heart, and hands. Now, it's hard to believe, but some of these students don't know this song. It's a shame, right? It's a shame. Well, today is our gift to you. We're going to perform now our version of Elvis Presley's In the Ghetto.
As the snow flies on a cold and gray Chicago morning, another little baby child is born in the ghetto. And his mama cries, 'cause if there's one thing that she don't need is another hungry mouth to feed in the ghetto. People, don't you understand? That child needs a helping hand, or he'll grow to be an angry young man someday. Take a look at you and me. Are we too blind to see? Or would we simply turn our heads
hungry little boy with a runny nose plays in the street as a cold wind blows in the ghetto. And his hunger burns. So he starts to roam the streets at night, and he learns how to steal, and he learns how to fight in the ghetto. Then one night, in desperation, that young man runs away. He buys a gun, he steals a car, tries to run, but he don't get far. And his mama cries. As a crowd gathers round, an angry young man face down in the street with a gun in his hand in the ghetto. As a young man dies on a cold and gray Chicago morning, another little baby child is born in the ghetto. And his mama cries.
Wow, that was powerful. I didn't expect to get up here and be emotional. What an honor to be together as trustees and students and faculty and all of these awesome, y'all are awesome, representatives and alumni to come together and to celebrate. It almost feels like a wedding. Celebrate what God's doing. This is a new era. This is a continuation of what God has as ministry, as the kingdom of God at Mississippi College. And I'm honored to be here. My name is Keely Wood. I'm a student at Mississippi College. Below we have Kyle, Emily, and Belle, and they're standing with President Thompson. That's him right there. And together right now, I invite all students. If you're a student at Mississippi College, even the Honors College, new students, I think y'all are going to be new students, are welcome to come and pray, put their hands on Dr. Thompson right now and pray for him. So right now I invite you. You can stand and make your way over here. I met Dr. Thompson this summer. I knew that he was the president because his face was already on Mississippi College's website. And I was bebopping to Cups, and he was meeting with Dr. Ward, and I love Dr. Ward, if you know him. And so I went up there and I introduced myself and we got to talking, and I had walked away and the Spirit put on my heart to come back and pray for Dr. Thompson. And I said, well, okay, I'll do it. And I got back up and went back to the porch, and I said, can I pray for you? And we prayed and the Spirit led, and it was an invitation and opportunity to see. Or it was an encouragement to Dr. Thompson already that this is why God had brought him to Mississippi College. And so now I feel like he's overwhelmed. I'm looking at his head shaking and all the students looking at him. This is sweet. This is a moment. I invite all of us right now, if you are a faculty member, a trustee, an alumni, a parent, a friend, heart to heart, we're gonna pray. We're gonna pray for him, we're gonna pray for the school. And we're gonna ask the Lord to bless this time. Close your eyes, bow. God, thank you. Thank you for the gospel. Thank you that we have breath in our lungs and in life because you decided it. You said, I love you and I'm gonna make you. I've knit you together in your mother's womb and now I'm gonna give you life. And thank you that we can stand here today united by your Spirit. So we thank you. Thank you for Dr. Thompson. Thank you for leading him here. Thank you for the men and women that you've put in his life to mentor him, to disciple him, to prepare him for what you have for him now. Thank you for his family. For Jana, Sarah Blake, and Kate, and Gray, thank you for bringing them over here. Thank you for protecting him. Thank you. Thank you for what you're leading them into. Lord, I pray for this school. I pray for a ministry-mindedness, a like-mindedness that we have in your spirit. One body, one faith, one hope, one baptism, Lord. I pray that we can be a like-minded community in this institution to not only be a college, but be an example of the body of Christ. Lord, we need you. We need to be reminded every day of truth, who we are in you, Lord, and so we acknowledge that. We acknowledge our neediness. Lord, and we thank you that you put men and women and family and students and professors and staff to come along us to be reminded of who we are in Christ. And so we praise you. And I pray specifically for Dr. Thompson that you arm him with the armor of Christ, Lord. Arm him with the helmet of salvation, the belt of truth, the breastplate of righteousness, the shoes fitted with the readiness of the gospel of peace, and the shield of faith, which is able to extinguish all of the flaming darts of the enemy. Lord, and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Thank you. Thank you that you've given us everything we need for life and godliness. You've called us your workmanship, created by God, to do good works, which you've already prepared in advance for us to do, Lord. And we acknowledge that. We have confidence and joy and excitement for what you are bringing our school into, bringing Dr. Thompson into our lives, into leadership as the president. And we praise you and thank you for this new era. Lord, I ask that you give them support and encouragement in the little ways and the big ways, whether it's a smile from a student or it's a deep one-on-one conversation with a mentor faculty member. Lord, will you give like-mindedness in ways that could not have happened apart from your spirit at work? And will you continue to remind us that we are nothing apart from you? Apart from you, we can do nothing, Lord, but you give us the privilege to remain in you. You tell us that we can call you Abba, Father. So we thank you, thank you, and thank you. Lord, I ask that all that we do in word or deed be to your name and your name alone at Mississippi College now and on. We love you and we praise you, and we say this all in your name. Amen. I don't know who's coming after me.
Well, amen. Thank you, students. There is no more important thing that we will do today, this lawn, than intercede on behalf of our new president. In a moment, we're going to sing our alma mater. You'll find the words on the inside back cover of your program. And after we sing, remain standing for the benediction. Let's all stand now and sing our alma mater together. The crest of a hill, staunch as a rock is our dear alma mater. Round her so noble our hopes ever live. When in the future our hearts may be yearning for the bright scenes of our dear college, back to thy portals our memories turning, clear beams thy
we join our hearts together in a prayer of benediction. Father, God of love, God of grace, God of mercy, we're so grateful for the opportunity to be here today in this place to install, to invest not only our choice for president of Mississippi College, but we're grateful to say we're here to install your choice. We celebrate today not only the vision of Dr. Thompson, but we understand that we celebrate and share your vision. Lord, gathered here, we pledge to you to come alongside Dr. Thompson and his leadership to use our head, our hearts, and our hands in service of your kingdom here at Mississippi College, in this community, in this state, in this nation, and indeed in this world. And Lord, we do ask now, as we close, we do ask your special blessings on our new president, my good friend, Dr. Blake Thompson. We ask that you bless him, you bless his family, you bless his leadership here in this place. And God, we do ask that you continue to bless our dear and beloved Mississippi College. We ask all of this humbly in the name of your Son, the Prince of Peace. Amen and amen.
Say it again, say it again.
Say it again, say it again. Right.
Thank you all for joining us today. Will you all please join us as we go to a reception in the piazza in Jennings Courtyard. Have a blessed day.